biggest question of the day here on our love letter is, our firstborn is not my son. What should I do? Now, apparently, a gentleman is writing to us saying that, hello, Aben, today. I married my wife almost 30 years ago, but only because she was pregnant. I was reluctant to take her in, but due to pressure from my mother, I gave in. I was almost sure that I was not responsible for the pregnancy, though. She gave birth to a baby boy who is now a young adult. Some 10 years after we got married, an old man from a neighboring village started claiming that the boy was of his grandson. I confronted him about it, but he was evasive, yet he continued claiming the boy. I talked to my father-in-law about the matter, but he was not of much help. Apparently, I knew that the purported father of my boy since we grew up together, seeing each other. Years later, my wife's phone rang while we're having supper. She did not receive the call, but instead disconnected it and deleted the number, which I thought was peculiar. I demanded an explanation, and of course, she told me that it was a pastor who was hitting on her. I did not buy the explanation and decided to investigate the matter, which led me to the suspected father of my son. To cut the long story short, my wife later admitted that the boy I had assumed was my son was indeed another man's son. What should I do? In the first place, I want us to put into consideration that this man married this woman in the name of her being pregnant, but now things have turned out round, finding out that this is actually not his son.
Mudiao ah. Anyway, today you could tuatandikide wasiku ABC. Abstain.
Be faithful.
Be faithful. Use a condom.
But it has to have a formula.
Dinda ko.
If you can't.
We receive.
Ime ya so say.
Dinda ko.
Namwe bulavu niga tugenda.
Bulavu zija kukamunika ngate ngo nyingi. Love niga wefu. Gendo.
Yi.
Kakati olaba ya. This boy knew he had actually slept with this girl, so he wasn't sure if the child is his or not. It takes me back to abstain. You know you don't love the girl, but you just want the thing between her legs. Go and find it from somebody you love and care about. Why are you just testing waters? Stop testing people's waters. No. Keep yourself to yourself and be able, allow yourself marry somebody you love. Because when you marry somebody you love, because when you sleep with somebody you love, then you can marry them.
But do you know
that just any cookies.
You may just put a comma there. Do you know that you can fall in love with someone because of their National Water and Sewage Corporation?
Why? No, you decide. Are you in love with the waters or are you in love with the person? Now,
you can be.
Are Derek?
You can be. Derek, no, I'm not speaking on my behalf. I'm speaking on someone else.
10 years.
But vanja batula besa wazine ime. Nkubuziza ochimanyi nto inzo gwamukwano
no
muntu.
No, you just said water. You see, when it comes to the game, I tell people, you'll be lucky to find somebody who can go even 20 minutes. This thing is like... like 2 minutes. I don't even know. Now, because of the 2 minutes.
So what take a comment out. We just agami on kwen number.
Because of the 2 minutes, this guy has spent 30 years with a woman he doesn't love.
Yeah.
They are in a fake marriage because he was forced to marry someone he didn't love, but because the girl was pregnant.
Yes.
It happens a lot. But for me, when it comes, this case has actually confused me. I feel the man's pain when he's writing. You can actually, I feel his pain, and I can just say sorry, and train the children better. Tell them to wait until they get somebody they love, and then maybe then they can play the game. You know,
okay.
The game requires when you're in love with the person, but. Since we are in the era where tetetula are just bugere, edda by the way to check paternity, bakebedango bugere, edda batunuranga maso gomwana, bakebeda matu. There's something about an earlobe. When you talk to somebody older, they can look at a baby as little as the child is and as undefined as the child is. Abantu abakurukuru basobola okulaba nti ono mwana waffe, ono mwana si. So take the children to your parents, they can identify. Now, right now, tudina DNA. Chabakola chi? Chabata andikidako.
Okay.
Atuwaro mwana mu DNA.
Njagala tukudilo, tubudilo, mwana babanga siwe, akule hacho. Kwanga chenyini, chenyini, chatubuza. Willis, kalavu niga. Chie chigenda maso.
Semyekozo.
Wawasa.
Nelea sinza gamba lavu niga kuwasa nina. Jevali, baravuniga.
Yacho get that.
Ne, ba mubaravuniga bwawe. Mbawe chiti bwangapo. Basigale bwaravuniga bwawe.
Okay.
But moving on to the letter. One is that I want to disagree with Imi, just briefly, where she says that it's wrong for you. The way I understand it, don't get married to someone because of, you know, 2 minutes because of a baby. And wrong. I would like to say that people start relationships because of very many reasons. You can never say that this relationship will work because they started on a wrong foot or a bad foot. When a man realizes that the person he slept with is pregnant, just like the woman's life changes when she finds out she's pregnant, the man's thinking and life also changes automatically. He begins to think about school fees, diapers. He begins to, you know, not look at slay queens as slay queens, but look at them as money wasters. You understand? That's what happens in a man's mind. So when a man, when he found out that she was pregnant, he probably, it probably clacked, like, I'm now a man. What next? What do I do? I do not want to shame my parents that, you know, I had a kid outside.
Even the girl's family.
Even the girl's parents. Let us get married before the baby comes, which I disagree with. I think that, and for people out there, if you ever get someone pregnant, do not marry them before the baby comes.
Why?
Because
if the child is yours,
you're playing around with very many lines in life. One, there is the new life. Two, there is the mother. Three, there is you. These are three different lives that are trying to all be in one. So when you put marriage as a life, you're trying to sort of have
it's a lock in. Eh?
You understand? So let someone have the peace of mind to carry the baby without stress of thinking about budgets and cakes and where honeymoon, let them give birth properly and easily. Then after that, you can sit and say, you know what? I think, you know, let's do this. You understand?
Those Waluo cultures are a bit
different. So
like in the Luo culture, in the Luo culture, you are not allowed to marry a pregnant woman. Actually, they don't let you marry because Sanyambinyo, women die. So usually they used to protect the boy child into ayinzo kukubembaga ate then mukuzala no kodachi no itirayo. But what I am seeing here, this is 30 years ago, and 30 years ago, I mean, I'm 34. Well, 30 years ago, I have friends, twachimanga amazzi kuluzzi, and very many things used to happen. When
30 years ago, you were 4 years of age.
No, 30 years ago. No, 30 years ago, I was four. Nga tuchabela no mchivuga, but we went to the village when I was, I think, seven. But I saw
a lot of things used to happen.
I'm telling you, Linda Ko.
What things happened when you were seven?
Ati, I'm telling you.
Ime kwa wafamu viku eno jivuka.
Linda
Ko.
By the way, nakuma until I was 26 years old.
Hii kale mukama kulaba.
Ne mukama na yachi manyi. And saa papa angamwe. So it takes me back to...
Saa gale ukose kwa example. Ukose seno. Nene wali yomu untu.
Okay. Guys, at that age, they like to experiment with their bodies. Ate mubiaro, there is a lot of freedom and fun. I'll tell you this. There is a lot of... uninspected, unsupervised things going on. So you will find that if you find a loose girl, she is loose and generous. And if you find a loose boy, there's no if on a boy. Very many boys usually were very experimental. Nabano nyanyo ebintu,
if
tekoda. So very many times, actually, I always tell people, supervise these children. Children, at some point, they experiment and try and discover their bodies. But now, here is a guy. The guy is writing, he knows the father of the child. He knows the grandson of the child. You understand? So now the grandson, the actual grandson of the child was looking on the side, was standing on the side and just saying, let the child grow, let the child grow. But ya munde teda. Kati yono musajia, inevitably. Akuziza. Well, there are very many couples like that. I know some people who are raising kids who are not theirs. Kudos.
No, me, I think, one, that you're going to have the shock of your life. Because, one, you're not sure. And you're not sure that the baby is yours, but you're also not sure that the grandfather is sure. You understand? Oria kugamba bugambi ti wangi. Na ito li shua ti ali shua. Inzo kuba na yate vili zavu.
Na yae inzo kubanga ti ali shua.
Ngati ali shua.
naye ffe engeri gye tulimu shua
naye
avuddeyo n'atugamba mu she at the end of the day she confessed and said that this is not your son. Omukazi
no, let them just do a DNA.
We're going to go in for a very short break. Penyari jetu li shua tugenda kugama. Ntipu tuko mawa studio lines zigenda kuanga zili open, of course. The number yotu kubilake is right there on your screen. 0414-337-872. Bojikuba vote. Ogenda kubango uliku shua. Yoko gila nafiwana musudia. And of course, give us some advice regarding this love letter.